Okay, great. We now have our UI defined, and our Android manifest is almost done. But because we're using Google services, there's one meta tag that we need to add, and that's just to specify that we're using the Play Services library. We do that like this. The metadata tag is used within the application tag, and it should be a sibling of the activity, not a child. Within that, you specify Android name is com.google.android.gms.version, and the value for this is @integer/googleplayservices_version. Now, as you can see here, it's showing up red. It's showing up there's an error, you can't resolve symbol, but we're going to fix that in a moment. And also, once that's been fixed, your application's been configured to use these services libraries, whenever you compile, this will be filled in automatically with the correct number. So let's go ahead and do that. So in order to do that, there's one other place that we need to ensure that we're using the libraries for the services, and that's in the build.gradle for the app itself. So if I go into the build.gradle for the app, down here you can see the dependencies at the bottom of build.gradle. And we're going to add a new dependency in here. So what we want to add is quite simply to compile com.google.android.gms:playservices:6.5+. Now it's important to note that your version here may be different. It depends on what you're using and what version of Play Services you've installed. You can take a look in your system to see what versions have been installed for you. And I'm just using this plus just to make life a little bit easier. I believe I have 6.5.0.87. But of course, by the time you're watching this, Play Services might be at version 7 or later. And as you can see here, you should avoid using plus and version numbers because it can lead to unpredictable behavior. But I'm just going to leave it in for the time being for simplicity. But do note when you're building your applications that you should use the correct version number here. So now once we've done this, we're going to go to our main activity and we're going to access the location provider. Now in our main activity, remember that it contains just a single text view. And when the user runs the app, we wanted to get the current location using location services and write the latitude of the current location into that text view. In order to do this, we're going to need to write some code in the activity. This code will create the Google API client and set up the required callbacks to catch responses back from location services.